гул такой, и начали сыпаться. И мне вон в руку попало, вот он. Она уже заживает, правда, но тут кости нет у меня. Надо еще делать операцию, кость надо вставлять.
During a week-long investigation on the ground in eastern Ukraine, Human Rights Watch has found widespread use of cluster munitions. Our evidence shows that the Ukrainian armed forces were responsible for at least some of these attacks. In the incidents documented by Human Rights Watch, cluster munitions killed at least 6 civilians and injured dozens.
В это время упал эта бомба вот тут вот. Если хотите, могу эту яму показать.
Да.
И взорвалась, и прямо в окно, как его, она стояла возле окна. И разбила окно, этот осколок, и вот так вот сонные артерии перерезала. Я пришел, а я оттуда иду, тут люди. Ага. Я пошел, хотел туда идти, а там смотрю, люди кричат: дядя Ваня, тетю Раю убила.
The cluster munitions that Human Rights Watch has documented in eastern Ukraine are surface-to-surface weapons. They're rockets. And within those rockets, there are dozens of submunitions or smaller bombs which explode when they hit the ground. The problem with cluster munitions is that they cover a wide area. And anybody who is in that area, whether they're civilians or combatants, run the risk of being injured and killed. And that is why it is an inherently indiscriminate weapon.
Упав от это, почувствовал, що заложило уши, і увидел, ну, как со спины вот это закрывает пылью, землею, как волна как накрывала. Да, пробито одно легкое. Сейчас потихоньку восстанавливается, но еще не до конца.
The first clue that cluster munitions have been used is usually the presence of multiple impact craters with a very distinctive fragment pattern.
After the detonation of the submunition, the fragments are ejected and these melt. They melt into the asphalt as they come out.
At these impact sites, we also find very often remnants of the submunitions or of the rockets themselves. And witnesses also told us what it sounded like when the attack happened, that it was multiple smaller explosions, which is typical of a cluster munitions attack, instead of single larger ones.
А ви помните, какой звук был, когда это упало? Вы можете описать звук?
Гул такой. И так, и начали бух-бух-бух сыпаться. Они оттуда начали лететь, сыпаться, и вот так пошло.
Since all the parties to the conflict in eastern Ukraine use the same weapons, it's sometimes difficult to establish with certainty responsibility for a single attack. But for several attacks on Donetsk in early October, we have very strong evidence that it was the Ukrainian armed forces. The impact site showed that these rockets came from the southwest, and when we went there to areas controlled by the Ukrainian government forces, we found misfired rockets that showed that the rockets came from that area.
We are in the middle of a sunflower field about 16 to 18 kilometers south of Donetsk. This confirms to us that we're in the flight path that in the areas that Ukrainian military forces are firing surface-to-surface rockets into Donetsk. And also confirms to us that they're using cluster munitions among these rockets.
Another problem with cluster munitions is that sometimes these submunitions fail to explode on impact. But they're very unstable, so if they get disturbed, they might explode and kill and injure civilians. And we saw dozens of such unexploded submunitions during our investigation in eastern Ukraine. 114 countries have signed a treaty to ban the use of cluster munitions. And although Ukraine is not one of those countries, firing cluster munitions into populated areas is still a violation of the laws of war and may amount to war crimes.